Hey, welcome. It is Wednesday night, and we're here to talk some ball. My name is Nate Allball. I happen to be an assistant football coach at a small school known as Unity.
I'm Tim Turner. I'm the head football coach at a little bit bigger school named Champaign Central.
Yes, we've had some good arguments over the years of who would win between Central and Unity on a given year.
Yeah.
A lot of people would assume, a lot of guys on our staff,
right,
were like, no, we're too big for them.
We're too big.
And I was like, I don't think that matters.
So. Yeah. I don't think it matters.
Football we're close enough.
And that's the beauty of the game, though, coach.
Yeah.
Right? Like, the size of your school doesn't really matter. When it's Friday night, Saturday afternoon,
whatever it may be,
man. Let's put the helmets on and let's see what happens.
And when you're loaded, you're loaded. Yeah. Your team should be a load this year.
Yeah.
How are you dealing with that pressure?
Well, there's no pressure. There's never any pressure.
No pressure.
Well, okay. The expectations,
yes,
right? Expectations have risen, which is great. But there's no pressure because the kids are having a great time right now. I'm telling you, Coach, summer's going great. Kids are bonding the way that we need them to. We got a good group of seniors, and I'm excited, man. It's good.
That's exciting. Good. This has been one of those years that you've been able to look forward to for a while.
Absolutely.
Like this is that year. Hey, while we're chatting, hopefully you're checking in over on the side if you haven't already. And as we talk, feel free to ask questions, have your own conversation going. You don't have to just respond to what we respond to. If you're not watching us live or with the premiere, always as we love the comments below as well. We try to respond to those.
Sure.
So today we're talking to helmet sticker or to not helmet sticker, you know?
That is the question.
Reward stickers.
Right.
I have seen a lot of programs that just don't do it. I mean, just no rewards. And then you've got other programs that stickers
everywhere.
Everything.
Sure, sure.
Now, I know where I fall
easily.
Where do you fall?
Well, I think we fall kind of on the same place. I'm a man that believes you sticker it. Now, I am wondering now how many different ones you use and for what things, right? So for us, we do academics. You're going if you're a high academic honor kid, you're going to get a sticker, something special
mm-hmm.
for us. We do attendance, obviously we want you there, and we do strength. Those are the three that we do most often. And so, you know, I think it's about what you want to emphasize,
yes,
as a part of your program. And I think some of the best ways to do it, these kids are in this Twitter world. And,
oh, yeah.
Right? And it's everything's about look at me. And so we have, and this is going to sound silly, but I make sure the kids are uniformed, right? So, for example, nobody's going to wear pink socks for on my team. Nobody's going to wear, you know, the undershirt that's a different color or those things now. And so, these kids are wanting to stand out. So for us, one of the ways that they can stand out is by getting those stickers, right? So getting different stickers, that makes you a little bit unique.
You can earn it.
Yeah, you can earn it. You can earn a way to stand out. So I love that part of it.
Well, I'm a big believer in stickers. We would spend, when I was at Central, we would spend about $1,000 a year on helmet stickers.
Yeah.
Now, you don't realize at first just how expensive they are.
Yeah.
Now, you always did the ordering for us,
right,
so you were aware.
Yeah.
But we've had other assistants are like, that when the first time they see that bill, they go, oh, we're spending this much money on this?
Or boosters.
The boosters, yeah. So I have gone much more, and I'm, now this is a recent change, but I have leaned much more away from new uniforms.
Sure.
I'm tired of giving all my money to Nike, and always everywhere I'm going, I'm trying to find like what's a classic look that can maintain for a long time. Like Alabama, wear the same uniforms for how many years? Michigan,
sure.
Notre Dame, right? They don't have to go get the new uniform.
Sure.
We want to try to establish that so we can save money and spend it on some other things. And one of those things being stickers, because I believe in them so much.
Right.
You always said kids will do a lot for t-shirts, stickers, and pizza.
Yeah.
For whatever reason, they will. And it's like we grow up with it, right?
Right.
Sticker
right.
charts in the third grade.
Yeah.
I still remember getting my star for having been the first to get my three, my multiplication tables, the threes.
Right.
That was a big deal.
Yeah.
I wanted that star.
Huge deal.
So I love them. Right. I love them. But there's obviously a lot of different ways to do them. And those coaches that hate them, I'm wondering what they hate about it.
Well, here's what I'm going to say. I think one of the downfalls, and again, I'm a sticker guy, but I think one of the downfalls of it is keeping up with the stats that go along with those giving out those stickers and being consistent we're giving out those stickers. Because once you start to do that, kids are expecting those stickers, right? And so I'm finding myself right now, trying to find a balance between how many to give out. Because right now, I'm still the guy. So when I had you, I was the guy that, you know, ordered the stickers and made sure to get them out and all of those things. Well, right now, I'm still that guy.
But you haven't passed that off?
I haven't passed that job off yet.
You need to find a new coach team.
Yeah, coach, listen. All right, this is a whole other story. But, yes, that's great. But please correct me if I'm wrong. I didn't do the things that I did because you asked for that, right? I did the things that I did because I saw it as a part of what our program needed. I stepped up, and you said, great, here.
Yes and no. Let me tell you something I have learned at the new place that I'm at.
Okay.
The new guy that I coach under, again, he's been coaching for many years and has had a ton of success. Sure. His staff certainly respects him. And he's good to his staff. And, you know, the same thing. Like, they can poke fun of him and he'll laugh, yada, yada. But he absolutely designates and what's the word? That, you know, he's going to why can't I think of the word? Where you give it to someone else to do.
Delegate.
He delegates. Sure. You're going to do this. You're going to do this. They do this same summer camp every year. They go to Rantoul. Their kids stay in this old, really old, rundown hotel.
Hold on. I got to get you in our.
We. Our. What?
You said they.
Oh, it's now, we. We go. I'm not used to that. Okay. So we go to this camp. They've been doing it for years, and it was the last day. It was checkout day.
Right.
And one of the assistants is upstairs on the third floor checking the kids out of rooms. Final checkout, right? You got to walk through. Well, the head coach walks around the corner, and the assistant goes, what are you doing here? And he says, I was helping the kids check out. He says, you haven't done this in 12 years. What are you doing here? Right. So it just kind of – you see that this guy has delegated. So I will say this. When I saw that you were willing to work, then I was willing to pour the work on.
Right. Well, I am still looking for those. I'm still looking for those guys.
You just got to make them.
And what I'm learning, and I think that's part of it too, right? I have to find someone that's willing and then just put, I think one of the best things you did was just ask more. And if we couldn't do more, then we could say, hey, coach, hold on a minute, right? But the ask more part, and I need to get to that.
Because you can't do everything that I was doing back in the day and everything you were doing back in the day. And that's what you're doing.
That's what I'm doing.
Yeah, you need to – let's delegate. Okay, we're off topic. You guys got – how does your head coach do at delegating? Right. Is he good at it? Do you think he could ask more of guys? Last thing, let's talk about what to give helmet stickers for.
Sure.
I am a big fan of just one reward sticker. I've played with a lot, as you know, that we've worked together a lot. I've played with a lot of different ways, maybe different things on the helmet.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a fan of one because it looks uniform.
Sure.
However, the one thing we tried that was different that I absolutely love and would like to keep forever was our badge system.
Sure.
So I should have had you bring some of them badges in. Yeah. You still got the badges?
I still got them.
Are you going to use them this year? I know you were debating.
I'm still debating.
So we had a badge system. So we had our reward stickers that would go on through the season. But you could earn badges over the summer. And that's going to be like the back of our helmet would look like, you know, a military man's got all of his badges above his breast pocket. That's what the back of our helmet would look like. Right. And so we established that anything that we valued needed a badge.
Yeah.
Okay. So we value attendance. That was a badge.
Yep.
We valued you playing year after year. That was a badge. That was the veteran badge. We valued your grades. That was a badge. We valued you playing multiple sports.
Yeah.
That was a badge. We valued you being strong. So we rewarded you for that. There was a badge for that. We valued your speed. There was a badge for that. We valued
fundraising.
There's a badge for that. And
community service.
Yeah. We had a badge for all those. The kids could earn the badges in the back of their helmet. Boom. I'll have to grab a picture, maybe try to throw it up.
Sure. Yeah.
I like that.
It's something that I'm only toying with because I got this. I want to show it.
Yes.
It doesn't mean anything to anybody except for my guys. We got a new helmet this year. So, you know, in the past we've had either a maroon or a white helmet. So this year we're rocking a black helmet. So That's exclusive.
Still with the infamous logo.
Oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah. I had toyed around with changing the logo a little bit. Asked my leadership council what they thought about it, and early on it was, because it's the new ones that I have are sharp. At least I think.
Yeah.
Early on, those new ones were winning. I gave them 3 days, right? I gave them 3 days. And early on, the new ones were winning. I had 18 guys in the council. The first 11 or so chimed in. And early on, it was, let's go with the new thing. But late, the old faithful stayed around.
After sleeping on the kids, after sleeping on my cousin, I really not want to have.
And I love it. So back anyway, the reason I brought this out, that's what I'm toying with as to whether or not I still use that badge system, because I'm not sure how well it'll show up on this new helmet. So sure. I'm just waiting to see about that. But sure, I think having some kind of badge system, some kind of system that allows the kids to earn something for their uniqueness, whether it be their grades, whether it be, because some kids aren't going to get on the field very much, right?
Right.
And their honor to the team is, hey, coach, I show up every single day and give you everything I got. I may not be the best player here, but I show up and I'll give you everything I got. He should have a badge for that, right? As opposed to, I've never really been a proponent of, pancake blocks or these different things that are just simply individual accolades that only the best of athletes can really do, right? So we talked about attendance. Every kid in your program can show up every day, right? We talked about community service. Every kid in your program, big, small, whatever, he can do community service. Every kid in your program can do fundraising. Every kid in your program, if you set the system up correctly, should be able to earn some kind of badge for his strength or his speed. And I think when you set it up that way, then you're winning something. But if you put these, I think what I'm trying to say is it has to be goal. It has to be stickers that can be attained, right? Don't put it at a spot where it's hard for kids to reach it, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, I think the best thing we ever did was had many kids with littered helmets back then, right? And so kids are looking and saying, hey man, what'd you get that sticker for? It's like, hey, I only missed one summer workout last summer, so I got these stickers. Or I've been a part of this program for 3 years, so I get three more of these stickers, right? And so I think those are the things that really help when you go to a sticker program.
Well, I think the cool thing about high school football, and I've learned this more and more in the last few years, of course, with traveling so much and interviewing so many coaches. The cool thing is that you're not on TV.
Right.
You're not under any sort of contract or obligation. You really have this huge amount of freedom with your helmets.
Right.
It's a great opportunity to one of your best opportunities, in fact, to build motivation into your program, into your culture. And I think if you don't do it, it's just like it's a stone you're leaving unturned.
Right.
Why leave it unturned?
You're missing out on something that you could get something.
Yeah, and whatever reason you're going to give me, unless it is we truly don't have the money.
Sure.
Which I would still argue, say just buy some, stop spending on whatever you're spending on. But I just don't think that it would be as big as this opportunity to motivate your kids.
Right.
But anyway, Peoria High School had a great one. They just went straight off Call of Duty like 7 or 8 years ago, and Call of Duty was huge. And like you ranked up basically.
Right. Right.
You ranked up, and like he only had, what was his name? Kendrick Green, who ended up going to University of Illinois. He said is the only kid that's ever earned five-star general in my program. So, man, the sky's the limit. Why leave that stone unturned?
Right.
Who can argue that? Leave it. Come on. Why leave that stone unturned?
I don't think they can argue it, Coach. I don't think there's any argument for it. I think the only argument is you just said it is if it's a money thing.
Yeah.
Right. If it's a money thing, sure. That where do you spend money? I think that's probably a good show too, Coach.
Where are you spending your money?
Yeah. Where are you spending your money?
Stop buying new uniforms every year.
Yeah. I don't know, though.
I know, because he wants uniforms.
I want uniforms.
Stop wasting your money. Give your money to somebody else.
Right.
All right, let's get out of here.
Hey, guys, we appreciate you. When we show up, we're here to kind of hang out, talk a little bit of football. We're not proposing that we know anything more than you. We just want to keep the conversation going. So we appreciate you being part of the conversation with us. And until next time, love, peace, and hair grease.